Another participant in the development of design principles is Arthur Riel, whose book is titled Design Heuristics, referenced on the class resources page. Here are some examples of Riel's heuristics. You will notice the overlap with some of the principles that we have already talked about. These particular heuristics don't have names that are catchy like the law of Demeter, but they do exhibit advice to you about situations that you want to avoid or ways of structuring your code that you want to try to promote. First one is, most of the methods defined on a class should be using most of the data members of the class most of the time. Otherwise, there's an opportunity to split the class into pieces that individually obey this principle. Another Riel heuristic, check constraints in constructors rather than in method preconditions where possible. Following this principle will reduce the overall amount of checking that needs to be done by the class. Another heuristic, factor the commonality of data, behavior, and interfaces as high as possible in the inheritance hierarchy, thereby facilitating reuse. This, of course, is standard OO dogma. Here's another Riel heuristic. Inheritance should be used only to model a generalization hierarchy and not to facilitate the sharing of implementation code. We've heard this one many times in this course. Another, prefer composition, which we can also think of as aggregation or delegation, over inheritance, particularly with respect to implementation inheritance. Another, it should be illegal for a derived class to override a base class method with a no-op method. That is essentially a method that does nothing instead of the behavior that the base class prescribes. Doing so, by the way, would violate the substitution principle that we saw earlier. Riel also suggests that we not change the state of an object without going through its public interface. Doing so would violate information hiding. If we kind of extend this idea to deal with subclassing and we strictly obeyed it, this heuristic, it would mean that a method in a class cannot change an instance variable without calling the setter method in that class. That is, you couldn't make a direct assignment to an attribute, you'd have to call the setter which did it. Another Riel principle, users of a class must be dependent on its public interface, but a class should not be dependent on its users. Finally, here are two Riel heuristics indicating how you should distribute key design knowledge among the components of a system. Distribute system intelligence horizontally as uniformly as possible. That is, don't artificially concentrate knowledge in one place. This heuristic is sometimes expressed as, do not create God classes or God objects in your system. A corollary heuristic is to distribute system intelligence vertically down narrow and deep containment hierarchies. I encourage you to have a look at Riel's book, where there's many more such pieces of advice.